Hi friends, welcome to EduTap. So welcome to the fast track series for NABARD Grade A 2018 examination brought to you by EduTap. Now this is a regular series wherein each day we come up with a new lecture which has short concepts and important data points that are very important for your examination. Now this is lecture 15. So friends, yes, finally the phase 1 examination is over and we are heading towards phase 2 exam, which is going to be held on 17th of June 2018. So EduTap has also come up with a new course where the course is going to be exclusively for phase 2 and the full course can be bought for a price of ₹3,500. And if you want to know more about our course, you can visit our website www.edutap.co.in. You can also drop us a mail at hello@edutap.co.in or you can give us a call at 814-620-7241. So friends, let us just gear up for phase 2, and today's lecture is going to be a bit short because we are just starting off the preparation for phase 2. Let's take it slowly. So friends, what we shall do is we shall, like always, pick up important concepts and data points, and it is going to be very crisp. So you need to make sure that you revise the series ample number of times so that you do not forget these information before you step into the examination hall, right? So first things, we're going to have a little bit of information regarding carps today. Now what are carps? So these are a species of oily freshwater fish. Okay, this is important. And it is from the family Cyprinidae. Oh, I'm really not able to pronounce it. So kindly just have a look at it. And it is actually a very large group of fish which is native to Europe and Asia. Okay. So when I basically talk about this carps belonging to the family, you can have a look at the picture given below. This is basically a hierarchy of the animal kingdom classification, right? So basically it starts with phylum. Okay. And then it moves on to class. Then we move on to order, then family, genus, and finally the species come into play, right? So we are talking about family, so we are talking about the order that is placed right here. So these are fishes belonging to this particular family, that is Cyprinidae. Okay, so now these are very highly cultured and domesticated, okay, in aquaculture, and it is used for both food as well as ornamental purposes. Okay, so it has dual purpose. You can also note this. You can have a general idea regarding it. So the important point that you need to remember, it's a freshwater fish, the first thing, right? It belongs to the family. I'm not pronouncing it again. So this particular family, and it is also native to Europe and Asia, third thing, right? And it has dual purpose, fourth thing, for food and ornamental purpose, right? Next, this comes an important snapshot. So here you can have a look at important Indian major carps. Okay, so I'm not going to explain the difference between major and minor carps. This is not in the context of today's lecture, at least. So today, just have a look at what are the names of the important Indian major carps. There's this Katla, Rohu, and Rigal. Okay, kindly make sure that you revise these names again and again, and here are the scientific names. Even you need to be aware of this as well. Okay, then you have a list of minor carps. Okay, Kalbasu, Bata, White Carp, Pigmouth Carp, and Sarana. Again, you need to make sure that you are aware of the scientific names also, right? Because many places you may just find Labio Rohita. So you should not wonder what is it, okay? If you have read Rohu, you need to correspondingly make sure that you complete Labio Rohita as well, right? Now, next we are going to have a look at other important species also. So here you have a list of exotic Chinese carps. So under it you have grass carp, silver, common carp, tilapia, okay, and Dr. Fish. Then you have catfish under it. You have catfish, magur, and singhi. Okay, overall there's a category of catfish. Under that you have these names. Okay, then there's sports fish and brown trout. Actually, it's trout. I'm sorry, there's a mistake out here. It's trout. Okay, so there is brown trout and rainbow trout. So simultaneously, you need to know the scientific names as well. So I would request you to kindly pause the video out here and finish the names then and there, so that in examination, if you get an option like which of the following are important Indian major cups, right? So you would get three of you know the names of three important major Indian cups. So at least you would be able to locate the correct answer, right? So make sure you finish it then and there. Next, we have moved on to some basic terms. So this is going to be the last point of discussion today. So if you see, there are numerous terms that we come across when it comes to maybe fisheries, right? So let us just have a look at these terms. Though on the outer side, you might think there are so many similarities. Yes, there are similarities, but there are differences as well. So you need to know the difference, because in case you get the definition as part of the question and in the options you are stuck with all these three things that are mentioned on your screens, then there might be a possibility of going with the wrong answer if you actually don't know what that term means, right? So for example, if you talk about pisciculture, so let us just read the definition. So you are talking about breeding, rearing and transplantation of fish. Okay, you're doing all these things by artificial means. Okay, so this is fish farming basically. Okay, so you're breeding the fishes, you're rearing them, and while transition, you transplant them also. We are not going into the details of the entire culturing process. Okay, so just have in mind that when you do so with fishes in particular, it is called pisciculture. Okay, so it involves raising the fish all for commercially. Okay, you may use tanks or you may use enclosures, and the end purpose of usually you know, fish farming is raising the fishes for food. Okay, for commercial selling it commercially, right? So this is pisciculture, very simple. Now when you come to aquaculture, aqua usually means water, right? So here when you talk about aquaculture, first thing differentiating it from pisciculture, in pisciculture you're just talking about specifically fish farming, okay? But when you come to aquaculture, you're talking about the entire aquatic organisms, okay? They can be fish, they can be shellfish, even the plants that are grown underwater, okay? So basically we are talking about growing all types of aquatic organisms in the water bodies. Now these water bodies that we're talking about can be either marine water or fresh water. They may also range from land-based to open ocean production. Okay, so basically here just don't go deep into it, just on the overall perspective you need to have that aquaculture involves all the aquatic organisms. Plus, it also involves rearing them in either marine or freshwater species also, okay? So, this is a thing. Now, when you come to mariculture, okay, now what is this? It involves the cultivation of only the marine organisms, okay? So, here we are not, we are excluding all the organisms that can be cultured in the freshwater. So, when we talk about cultivating only marine organisms, then we call it specifically as mariculture. Okay, so usually if you see, it is done mostly to obtain the commercial products by using the marine organisms, like for example, cosmetics, okay, fish meal, cultured pearls, yeah, pearls are very famous, okay. So now, whenever you see any definition, you should be able to locate as to which kind of culture is it. Is it pisciculture? Are you using only fish? Or is it aquaculture, where you're cultivating a wide range of aquatic organisms? And if you're cultivating those organisms in both water bodies, freshwater as well as marine, that means it is aqua, broader term. Now, if you go deeper or narrow and you are choosing only the organisms that can be cultured in marine environment, or if they're only marine organisms, then you call it mariculture, right? So friends, these are the other courses that EduTap offers for NABARD grade A, and you can see it is a phase 1 plus phase 2 comprehensive course. We have a current affairs course and we also have a test series. Now these are the courses that is offered for RPI grade B 2018, and we also offer CTET course, which is launched in association with Grade A. So friends, with this we have come to the end of the lecture today. So basically, what did we see today? So we had a rough idea about the various terms that are used, like pisciculture, aquaculture, mariculture, right? Then we moved on to see what are carps. Okay, we usually hear this term in fisheries, like carps. So we saw under which family it comes, and basically it's a freshwater fish. And then you also located it is native to which country, for what purpose is it used, right? And then we moved on to have a look at the Indian major carps, okay, the three names that we had seen. We had also seen what are the minor carps there, the names alone. We didn't go into the technicalities of why they are called minor carps. And then we moved on to have a look at the other exotic carps as well, okay. So kindly pause the video, make sure then and there you are done with those terms. If you found this video useful, kindly like, subscribe and share. Till then, friends, thank you so much and happy learning.